Today I'm kicking off something I'm really excited about. It's called the Help Me Understand video series. You know, I get a lot of questions from current and potential clients about emerging technologies. So what I'm going to do in this video series is break down those technologies for you in episodes of 10 minutes or less. If you have an idea for a future episode, let me know. And I hope you enjoy the first installment in this series. Today's episode is Help Me Understand QR Codes. Now, you've probably started to see things like these on product packaging and marketing materials. Now, these are QR codes. The idea behind them is that a user can scan them with a smartphone or, let's say, a tablet, and it'll give them more information about the product. For example, if you saw a box of Cheerios in the grocery store and it had this code on, and you scanned it, it would take you to probably a website for Cheerios with more information. Here's some quick facts about QR codes. The QR in QR code stands for Quick Response. QR codes were invented by a Toyota subsidiary in the 1990s. QR codes have been very popular in Japan. QR codes can represent many different things. For example, a QR code can represent a few sentences of text, a web page address, a phone number, a SMS text message, a geocache location, a contact from your contact book, or even an appointment from your calendar. The sky is really the limit on what QR codes can be used for. They can be put on many different types of marketing materials like paper, stickers, signs, t-shirts, vehicle graphics, and really a lot more. Here are some real-world examples of QR codes in action. Realtors are using QR codes in the newspaper to point customers directly to their listings. Home Depot is using QR codes on their trees in their garden area to give customers climate and hardiness information on demand. It's really easy to create a QR code using some of the freely available tools today. Here, I'll show you how to create one. Okay, to generate a code, you want to open your browser window and go to this website address. This is one of the many free QR code generators out there. Now, this one's going to allow us to do a couple different things. It'll generate URLs, text, phone numbers, and SMS QR codes, essentially. So I'm going to type in solutionsunion.com/qr.html. and click generate, and it's going to generate the code for me. There it is. Now I can take this and put this pretty much anywhere, and that's all there is to it. QR codes only make sense if customers know how to use them. So here I'm going to show you how to install a QR code reader and how to scan a QR code using your smartphone. Okay, so to be able to scan in QR codes, what the customer will need is they're going to need a QR code reader, it's called. Now most of the time that'll be on a smartphone or a tablet of some kind, something like that. So what we need to do is install a QR code reader on this phone. So what I'm going to do is click on the market icon down here. Now BlackBerry and Apple also have similar things called maybe the App Store, something like that. But we're going to go to that area, and we're going to search for an app with the name something like QR code reader, which is what I have here for that first one, QR code reader. I'm going to click that, and it's going to return to me all the programs or apps that are available for QR code reader. I'm going to try this first one here called QR Droid. I'm going to click the install or free button here, and I'm going to accept the permissions. Okay. Now what it's doing, it's installing it currently as we wait here. You can see the little icon there, and it says it successfully installed it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to my home screen here, and then I'm going to start up this app by clicking this button here, which will take me to all the apps on this phone. Now here's the QR Droid app, so we'll get that started. And you can see it's got a couple different options. On the first area on the top here, these six or eight icons, says generate a QR code. So we can actually use this to generate one, which is kind of interesting. There's some different options there, but what I'm really looking for is this decode from that's down here at the bottom. You can see it says decode from saved image here, camera here, image URL, or history. So what we're going to do next is we're going to try and grab a QR code and use the camera to decode it. Okay, so we've got a QR code that's pretty much ready to go here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring the smartphone in here so I can show you how this is going to work when we scan this. So here's the smartphone right here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and click on the camera icon here. And you can see what it did is it essentially just showing me on the screen what's on the camera's looking at. So I'm going to point it at the QR code. And there it took a picture right away and it captured it. And what it's telling us is that that QR code translated into a web address here. You can see it. solutionsunion.com/qr.html. Now, there's a couple different things we can do with this. Open email, SMS, copy, or share. I'm going to just click open. It's going to open that web page for us. And there it is right there. And it says, congratulations, you just scanned your first QR code. So perfect. That's how it works. Well, I hope I've helped you understand QR codes. If you have any questions about QR codes or have seen any really good examples of QR code usage, let me know in the comments. And if you have any ideas for future Help Me Understand episodes, send me an email. Thanks.